Welcome to the 2022 Bash Plus, Burbank High School Animation's Best Animated Shorts. And this year, we added a plus sign as we had unique projects beyond the animated shorts that we wanted to share that show the power of student learning and the many different ways of creating. This is the time of year when everything I see developing and growing behind the scenes gets to a point of sharing for the world to see. Students pour their heart into their projects, combining all of their years of learning and artistic practice into realizing visuals that resonate. Coming back from the pandemic, this year was all about resilience and community. Our classroom studio is our refuge and our place to explore our ideas, grow our talents, and support our fellow artists. We found many ways of working together. Students created unique visuals for the drama department's Wizard of Oz, painted a piano to bring spontaneous music to our hallways, commiserated over Blender notes, wrote and rewrote and rewrote scripts for an original series, created both comedy and tragedy, utilized our updated sound studio for voice acting and music, and researched historical artwork to bring color and movement to an original score while our Burbank High School Symphony Orchestra performed. Students were also supported by Nickelodeon professionals in three different mentorship tracks, pushing them to rethink and refine their concepts. This is what is possible when we are together. Enjoy the Bash Plus.
We are CG Team Nasty Knots, a project about a fallen city that has succumbed to rising tides, pollution worldwide, and it is set in a place in Italy. I'm Jack. I designed two of the buildings for our project, also textured them.
I'm Hannah. I did the plans, and I'm doing some other props with the water.
I am also Hannah. I modeled two buildings and also did the texturing for them.
I'm Arden. I did a couple of props, so if you see a crate or a ladder, that was probably me.
I'm Daniela, and I did characters such as fish.
I'm CJ, and I did the boat.
We really hope that you guys enjoy our project, because we put in a lot of work over the past 5-6 months, and yeah, please enjoy.
Allow me to paint a picture in your head. Pollution is at an all-time high and oceans are rising due to a large increase in global temperatures. Sounds horrible, right? With our project, we wanted to focus on what would happen to Earth had humans done nothing in order to stop the things that were harming our planet. Fallen society pursues the idea that the Earth that people once knew as their home has been destroyed. People nowadays have to live on top of one another in order to survive. Living spaces are cramped, and not a lot goes on in this society, other than survival of the fittest. When we first started our project, we combined several concept ideas, including overgrown cities, rundown high-rise buildings, and a lot of water. Most of our concepts came from areas in Italy or Japan where civilization is surrounded by water, and living space is minimal. Starting from the beginning, we each started to model our individual work, may it be parts of a building or miscellaneous plants and props. Then, after slowly working on our pieces from the ground up, we sent each other our files so that they could be compiled together and textured and colored accordingly. Finally, we each sent out our final drafts and made our final composition.
Jones, the production manager.
I'm Elodie Lambert, the editor.
I'm Paige Comelay, the art director.
I'm Vanessa Lopez, a storyboard artist, and we are Lonely People Entertainment of Animation One.
Our stop-motion animation, Lonely Eleanor, is a love story between our two characters, Eleanor and Father McKenzie. The song is a cover of Eleanor Rigby by Cody Fry. There wasn't really a message, but it's a really cute story and we wanted to share it with you.
While 5 weeks seems like a lot of time, we're working constantly in and out of class. The amount of patience and organization needed to work with hundreds of pieces of paper was and still is terrifying, but we did it!
Thank you for being here, and please enjoy our animation. We hope to see you next year as Animation 2 students.
Up the rice in the church where the wedding has been. Lives in a dream, waits at the window, wearing the face that she keeps in a jar by the door. Who is it for? All the lonely people, where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong? Father McKenzie, writing the words of a sermon that no one will hear. No one comes near, look at him working, darning his socks in the night when there's nobody there. What does he care? All the lonely people, where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong? Rigby died in the church and was buried along with her name. Nobody came. Father McKenzie wiping the dirt from his hands as he walks from the grave. No one was saved. All the lonely people. All the lonely.
I'm Shannon Hong, and I'm a junior pipeline engineer at Nickelodeon. Here I assist the animation technology team with supporting software and tools for all the productions at the studio. I started as an intern last summer in the archives, and back in 2015, I was a mentee in the mentorship program with Burbank High School. It was my first time creating an animated short, and it made me really interested in the whole community and industry. Now I'm happy to come back as a mentor, and it's been a pleasure working with the students. I'm really proud of the work that they've done, and to everyone out there, I hope you continue to express your creative ideas and have fun.
Hi, I'm Max Wilder. I'm currently a senior, and I'll be attending CSUN for film.
Hi, I'm Melanie Hasi Rodriguez. I'm a senior and I'll be attending CSUN for computer science.
Hi, I'm Christina Lee and I'm currently a junior.
Hi, I'm Batav Manasin and I'm currently a junior.
Hi, I'm Jasmine Brisanio Juarez and I'm a junior and we're Team Crocos for the animated shorts Nickelodeon mentorship.
Our project is called Detective Dick. We hope you enjoy.
We came up with the idea initially because Our first story was in a museum, and we first had it with a security guard, and he was really bad at his job. We realized there wasn't as many opportunities for visual gags, and we know we wanted to have a comedy, so we switched it up to a detective to have more clever visuals to it. And our aim was to create a character that was both clueless but also very lovable at the same time.
Some challenges Team Krokos faced were learning how to properly time manage as a team, as well as working and figuring out schedules. However, our team was able to overcome this, and our greatest successes would have to be putting in a lot of our motivation and productivity towards this project and being able to execute it perfectly in our vision.
Killer Craig is still at large. Located across of a well-known LA bar on Charles Street, two of his newest victims were found in their home, both of them brutally murdered. Police now have the crime scene under investigation, with some of the best on their job. However, so far, very little is known about Killer Craig.
But the crime.
My lord. Detective! You made it. How did you get the address? Why did you get the address?
Reporting for duty, sir.
Okay.
A true detective can deduct anything. I'm a crime specialist, sir. Give me the 412 on the case.
Well, we only need to find the culprit's identity. But, why don't you assist on another case? Further away. Maybe take a break. Far off site.
Right. Well, understood, sir. I won't disappoint you.
Finally, he's gone. That guy's the worst.
Get me a black coffee, damn it!
Okay. I don't get paid enough for this.
Are you the waitress?
What gave it away?
I'll tell you what gave it away. I'm a great detective, that's what.
Dick, give me that. My lord, Killer Craig. The ID. The ID. It's his ID.
And now we're back to murder at a non-specific high school.
No. 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 No.
Well, Dick, you did it. You caught Killer Craig.
What did I do? Killer Craig?
Are you fast enough?
Are you expecting some kind of post-credit scene? This isn't Marvel.
Hi everyone, my name is Kri Balasanian. I am a senior student at Burbank High School. And starting from fall 2022, I will be freshman at one of the top music universities in the US, Boston Conservatory at Berkeley. I am here today to present one of the projects that Burbank High School Instrumental Music Association did in a collaboration with Burbank High School Animation Program. It is based on one of my compositions called The Maya. I wrote this composition after reading the book called The Maya by a famous American archaeologist, Michael Coe. I wanted to reflect the Mayan culture and their beliefs, and the animation crew put a lot of research into creating strong depiction of Mayan gods for each part of this animation. I am grateful to every person who worked on this project, because I know that students dedicated not only the time that they had at school, but also their personal time to work on this project and make it as incredible as it is. Thank you so much, everyone. I hope you enjoyed.
Hi, my name is Jacob Bui.
Hi, I'm CJ Rose.
Hi, my name is Louisa Ulmer.
We're all seniors here at BHS in our third year of animation. This animation, titled The Maya, was a collaborative piece with composer Grieg Balasanian. He reached out to us, asking for artwork to accompany this piece, and trusted us to execute his vision. We each put a lot of hard work into our concept art and animation, and it took a lot of time, but it all paid off. We hope that you enjoy.
The Maya was performed live at the BHS Band Show on May 6th, and conducted by the composer Grieg Balasanian. Today, you'll be viewing a shortened version of the full animation with computer audio. Now, without any further ado, we present The Maya. Thank you.
My name is Louisa Ulmer, and this year I am a senior, and I'm also in Animation 3. And this year I was really excited to try out stop motion animation for my short film, partly because it was a medium I was really inspired by as a kid. And first semester I focused on creating and building my main character and armature, as well as creating my sets and creating my storyboards. And second semester, this semester, I focused on filming, setting up the shots, as well as my editing. This film is called Trust Your Soul, which is a play on words for the Spanish word for sun, which is soul. And it's about basically learning to deal with feelings of isolation and loneliness, which I think are universal feelings that we all have, as well as feeling like you can't get out of your comfort zone or try new things out of a fear of how you will be perceived, as well as how those feelings can manifest into more destructive feelings. And ultimately, the importance of placing value onto yourself and knowing your own worth. So that is Trust Your Soul, and I hope you enjoy. Thank you. Thank you.
Or like you want to give up.
Hay que darle duro o hay que meterle mano.
Like things are really hard or you're frustrated in life. What are some things that you do?
When I feel like giving up, I tell myself the world would be a worse place.
Piensa eso. Tengo que meterle mano. Tengo que darle duro.
¿Cómo, mija?
¿Algo más o eso es todo?
I also find happiness through the things I like to do.
Pues pedirle a Dios que me diga que me ayudara.
Muchas gracias.
Que Dios la bendiga.
Hi everyone, my name is Evelina Nazari and I'm currently sort of zooming from the vault here at Nickelodeon Animation Studio. And here I work as a PA for the Nickelodeon Archives and Library Department, where our department helps support a lot of our asset management, where we collect, organize, preserve, and even promote access to physical assets, digital assets, and born digital assets across Nick Animation. And it's so cool to see how far the mentorship has come, because I personally was part of it 9 years ago for the inaugural year. So I'm really happy to see its growth and the way it's branched out through the efforts of Carson, Jonelle, and everyone in between. So hope everyone has a fun time, and I'm really excited to see what's in store.
Hi, my name is Spencer Nicholas.
I'm Griffin Slaughter.
I'm Leah Breyer.
And I'm Francis Bach.
And we are Family Flop, and our project is called Junkyard King.
It's a 1 minute animated short that we worked on for the past month. It's supposed to be a trailer of our upcoming show that we've been developing over the year.
We are all currently Burbank High seniors. In the future, I plan to go to the University of Utah to study game development.
I'm going to UC Riverside to study neuroscience.
I'm going to CSUN to study animation.
I'm going to Pasadena City College.
Thank you for watching this. I hope you enjoy our short.
Hope you enjoy. Support Junkyard King.
The Junkyard King. But what is The Junkyard King? The Junkyard King is a show about comedy, exploration, and the bond between a found family. Junkyard King is an animated series concept. The story is set many years in the future, after civilization has broken down. Our characters live in the junkyard, which is about the size of a city's downtown area. Here, all the resources needed to survive are accessible. Our stars of the show are Bingo and Gosha. Bingo is a hot-headed attention lover, while Gosha is sarcastic and more reserved. These characters have an explosive relationship. Their clashing yet loving personalities drive much of the show's humor and plot. Their relationship with their leader and parental figure, the King, is integral to the story. The King shows them family dynamic, teaches them right and wrong, guides them in their adventures, and acts as a mediator for all the chaos the characters get into. The King is the leader of the junkyard, and the parental figure to all the kids who live there. They create stories to help the children understand the world they live in. Besides those three, 13 other residents live in the junkyard too. Each go on their own journeys throughout the progression of the show and create conflict that make Gosha and Bingo grow. A lot of work went into this project. We created a 40-page show bible, which includes an in-depth explanation of the characters and settings, and a detailed synopsis for an entire first season of episodes. Our team scripted out an entire pilot episode for the show. We made sure to include dialogue that builds relationships between characters while also adding humor. Next, we continued on to storyboarding. Here we used perspective changes in order to create dynamic shots that are interesting to look at. Next, we worked on the animatic to plan out scenes for the trailer. Then we did animation tests, starting with rough lines, then clean lines,
then base color, then shading, and then finally background. Lastly, we voice acted our characters, and even got some professionals to help us out with the voices. And with that, that's Junkyard King. We hope you enjoy the trailer.
Once upon a time, a long, long time ago, a peculiar species called the human race roamed the world. In all of my travels, none of their creations have intrigued me more than the junkyard, isolated in an otherwise barren wasteland. The junkyard is what they threw away. For us, though, it represents a new beginning. What's that?
That's me! And that's Gosha, duh! Battle skills? I got that. Cool eye patch? Got that.
Did you check for your brain yet? No one's gonna want that. They'll see how much better I am at keeping things stable, and I'll gladly take the job.
Fight! Fight! Fight!
Two sworn rivals, raised together and trained to take the same throne.
Hey.
Oh, Nugget buddy, come on. We're friends, right?
I remember very clearly you said you, and I quote, found me annoying, and told me to never bother you again.
Who will come out on top?
Who will be victorious?
I'm going to be king, not you!
Who will be crowned? The Junkyard King.
Hey, look at this!
Good day, sir.
Come on, Bingo.
Youth.